All right, we're now ready to do the rear disc brake conversion on this 1966 Cadillac Fleetwood Series 75. The first step in doing the rear disc conversion is going to be to remove the old drum brake. So I'm going to start by removing the rear drum here, and that's just pretty much a standard procedure for any rear drum brake car. Okay, so the rear drum has now been removed off of the braking system. This nut right here was screwed into the axle shaft, so that was acting as a sort of retainer to hold the nut on. So if you don't pull this nut off, you won't be able to slide that drum off. But once I pulled it off, it was actually one of the easiest drums I've ever slid off of a wheel before. So with that off now, the next thing I'm going to do is disassemble the entire rear brake assembly. So I'm going to pull out all these springs in here, and I'm going to pull the shoes off as well. If you want to see the routine for this, check out my video from the front brakes. It's the exact same methodology. There's special tools you can use to remove each one of these springs carefully, but in this case, because I'm just going to be throwing out all of this and switching over to disc brakes, I don't have to be very careful about it, so I can just sort of rip these things out as long as I don't get a spring flying out and hitting me in the eye. Alright, so now that all the drum brake parts have been removed, the next thing that I'm going to do is try to disconnect the wheel cylinder from the brake line on the back, and this might end up being a bit of a challenge. And so that you can see what I'm talking about here, right there you can see there's a hard line that goes into the wheel cylinder. I've hit this with some WD-40, but the fittings on all the front brakes all stripped out on me, so I don't have a lot of faith in this one holding through. I guess we'll find out. Alright, so the brake line actually disconnected from the master cylinder without much difficulty, so it's nice to know I'll be able to reuse at least one flare fitting on here. Note now that the axle is not capable of turning, so I'm assuming there's a locking differential or something similar to that happening here, so I'm going to actually take the car out of park. Normally I always like to leave it in park whenever I'm doing a job like this, but I do have it up on a jack with a jack stand underneath for safety, and I have bricks in front of both the front tires, so in theory it shouldn't roll anywhere. And of course we want to make sure the parking brake is definitely not engaged, because of course we're going to be replacing the connection of it to the brakes here. I've already disconnected it on this wheel. So the axle shaft is being held into the axle housing by four nuts around here. And as you can see, there's a hole right here in the axle shaft, so I can spin it around to align with each one of those four nuts and unbolt it. So I've got to go and spin this around and unbolt all four of those, so that I'll be able to pull the axle shaft out of the actual axle housing. Alright, so the next step, now that I've got all of these nuts that are holding the backing plate for the axle removed from here, is that I need to slide the entire axle out of the axle housing. Now, the shop manual and traditional practices would have you use a slide hammer for this, but lately I've seen a couple of videos that show how this can be done just using the old brake drum, so I'm going to try that approach. So what I'm going to do is take the brake drum here and mount it backwards on some of the wheel studs that we have, and then I'm going to take the lug nuts for the wheel, and I'm just going to thread a few of them on here. I'll go ahead and put three on in this case. That should be about enough. And what we're going to try to do the axle out by using this brake drum as a hammer. So I should be able to budge it. I can get it loose. And there we go.
So you may have noticed that I rather hurriedly removed the axle shaft. Of course, the one time that I'm unlucky enough to have rain here in Southern California is right when I'm in the middle of this. But what you'll see here is that the axle shaft has these splines that go into the differential, and here's the back end of it. So that slid out rather easily. And it's just important to make sure that that doesn't get gouged up at all, so I set it on this cardboard box so that it would be safe. So the next step that we're going to do here is remove the backing plate, and that is possible because I disconnected the brake line, as you can see there. But down here you'll see that I do have to disconnect the emergency brake from that backing plate so that it's loose, and then I'll be able to attach the emergency brake to the new brake kit. Alright, so now that the backing plate has been removed, what I've done is I've taken gentle care to bend the brake line back out of the way a little bit so it doesn't get in our way. And you can see there's the emergency brake down there. And here's the bracket that came with the rear disc brake conversion kit from caddydaddy.com. What I'm going to do is install this so that this depressed edge here is facing outwards, and I want to line the holes up so that these two points that stick out towards the back here face the rear, and that will be where the caliper is going to mount. So I just sort of get that on there like this, and here we've got everything in place. Now you'll note that we have these bolts and locking washers on the back end here of the new bracket. Those are going to need to be tightened up, but I'm going to wait to tighten that up until I have everything else on. All right, so before I reinsert the axle shaft, what I'm going to do is take some of this grease here and just rub it around this seal, and that way we'll make sure that we don't get anything leaking out of there. Now the condition of the gasket on here isn't great, but I didn't think ahead to pick up one, so we're just going to sort of have to live with what we've got. I don't think it'll be too bad though. And the other thing I'm going to want to do here is sort of get some of the dirt and gunk off of this shaft right out at the end. So for that, I'm going to take this right here, this paper towel, and just sort of give that shaft a little rub down at the end there, try to get any of the gunk off of it. This doesn't have to be perfect, really. Car will probably need a new axle again someday, so no big deal. All right, so next I'm gonna put on these gloves here and we will reinsert the axle shaft. What I'm trying to do here is just sort of feel around for where this slides into the differential. May need to rotate a little bit, but sooner or later I should find that magic hole that this is looking for. Right, so we don't quite have it there. Closer to getting seated here, and then what I need to do is just get the splines lined up on this. So got these bolts right here, and let's get the backing plate in. Trying to get the bolts for the backing plate to sort of run through it, and there we go. The rear axle is now reinserted, and at this point I can now get it set in place and retained here with the nuts that I took off. All right, so now that the axle's back on and it's been tightened down, the next thing I'm going to do is tighten up these bolts right here, and these are the bolts that hold the assembly together to hold the caliper on there. So I'm just going to put a 11/16 wrench on one end and a ratchet on the other and get those tightened up. But they have the lock nuts on there, so they're a little bit stiff. So I won't be able to hold the camera while I do it. All right, so now that I've got these pieces tightened down on here real good, everything seems very solid in place here. And what I want to do next is attach the rubber brake line to the steel brake line so that we can run this onto the caliper. So I'm going to take this silver adapter here, and I'm just going to screw this down into the brass type piece that we have on here and make sure that that's on real tight. Once that's on tight, I'm going to attach it onto here, and we'll have this in place before the rotor's here, so that way the rotor won't be getting in our way. Okay, the rubber brake hose is now in place. The next step is going to be to place the rotor onto the hub. So we can see I've got two different rotors that came with this kit. I want to pick the one where the slots that have been cut into it make sense in terms of the direction that the wheels will be spinning. Since we'll be driving this car in the forward direction most of the time, that would mean that I want them arranged like this. So I'm going to put the rotor on now and the caliper next. In order to keep the rotor well seated while I'm going to put the caliper on here, what I'm going to do is take a couple of lug nuts and I'm going to put them on here and just get it finger tight so that way the rotor isn't tilted at an angle while I'm installing the caliper, because that'll just be one more wiggling thing to get in my way. Okay, the next step is going to be to install the caliper on the rotor. Now, when I received this caliper, it actually had the piston on the caliper that pushes the inner brake pad out sort of extended somewhat, and I tried to compress it back with the C-clamp and that didn't work. Come to find out that because of the integrated e-brake in this caliper, you actually need a special tool that will both rotate and compress the piston to get it back in. So I had to go and do that before I could actually get this onto the rotor, otherwise the pads wouldn't fit on the rotor. So now we're ready to go ahead and install the caliper onto the bracket that was installed, and that's going to go onto the bolt holes that can be seen if I pop the rotor off here. These holes right here, which are part of the bracket. One final thing that you need to do is you need to connect the emergency brake, and the end of the cable here from the original car should slide around, back, and through this little slot on the new caliper here. And once that's connected, then that should activate the emergency brake. And once you tighten down the caliper, everything is all set with the installation. Of course, I have to connect the brake hose as well. All right, so with the e-brake connected down here and with the brake hose connected, we are finally finished with the rear disc conversion. Now all we need to do is just bleed the brakes and everything should be all set.